Fascinating Nouns Extra.
I don't remember what. Oh, this explains some of the.
Just the clock.
It's probably going to be different. Yeah, it's not that.
It's just amazing. It looks like it's 100 years old. It looks like it came with the.
Yeah,
the clock.
No, this is a stationary that's.
Yeah, this thing, this whole thing is rigged up by hand. You know, Michael figured out how to make it work. And it's got these cables that go all the way to the top of the tower and around some pulleys, and it's a weight-driven clock.
Holy cow. Wait, so he took this thing, the crates came in, and he figured out how to put this thing together?
Yeah, yes, yeah.
He did it by hand? I mean, it's very intricate. You can see all the gears and, like...
Yes. When he first got it, when he first started putting it together, he had to figure out, you know, there was some instruction, but he had to figure out that there was a gear or two missing, and he actually had to find those or have them made. I think one of them he had made.
Oh, with a machinist?
Yeah, by a machine shop. But he got it all together, and he figured out how to make all the parts work, and it's something that was his crowning achievement, actually. It's something he had wanted since he was a boy. It was the last thing he did, too, and 1986 is the year we consider the castle finished.
When this was completed?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So the clock was the last thing pretty much to go in. The cables pull on hammers that hit on the bells. When we first installed this, Michael was such a good neighbor that he worried about what the neighbors would think. So, you know, we knew they would be loud. Those bells the big bell weighs over 2,000 pounds. And so Michael put a bunch of stuffing in some leather concrete gloves, cement gloves, and put them over the hammerheads. And so they'd be really soft, and everybody loved it. And it took about a year for them to wear out, and the bells slowly became louder and louder. And the whole neighborhood loves it now. And then, in fact, they'll call if it gets too far off time.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Maybe they can't synchronize their watches by it.
Can you reset this? Because, like, I'm looking at it now.
Yeah.
And it looks like it's...
Yeah,
have you ever moved it ahead to do it, or?
Yeah, you can't just do that, though. It's
not like in the cartoons, huh?
No, it's a whole process. You have to, like, actually stop the clock and then wait for what time it's going to be when you want it to be there.
Oh, wow.
And then start it again.
Wow.
And it has to be wound. It can be wound every 3 days, but that's a lot of work. So Jim Riley, who you met, mm-hmm. comes and winds it every single day.
There it goes. Supposed to make that noise?
Yes. Isn't that beautiful?
That is.